2 years around that time, the you know, all of it here was full of water. The water that goes to the Aurel Avenue, and it was just only full of water. And during the spring, you know, like the flood, the high just put all away the chapel and everything was destroyed. And because they still had a big devotion for Saint Anne, they decided to build another chapel. This chapel was just near that tree, but just up the hill, because that again will not be destroyed by the heist. And this one, for like many years around that, people have been coming there praying, and a lot of pilgrims came to that chapel. This is where also the first pilgrim here in Saint Anne de Beaupre came to that chapel. They were the first nation from Le Village Wendake to Quebec City. They were the first here, the first pilgrims to come to pray to Saint Anne. This was to the first chapel, the second chapel. Because a lot of people came to that little chapel, a lot of people came to pray and just to pray. They decided to build the first church. This represent, this is called the commemorative chapel. This represents the first church. Something kind of gray. This is like the bell, and this is the first bell from the first church. This is more than 200 years old. This like the first. This is at the same foundation as the first church. This is really old. And the first church was built in 1676 and was made like the one that you're seeing right now. For 200 years, people came to preach that church. And because again it was too small, they decided to build the first basilica, which looks like kind of this one, a little bit smaller, but the same placement. And it was kind of white, so it was not really like this right now. Unfortunately, in 1922, it was burned by a fire and everything was destroyed except one thing, which is the big statue that is on the top of the basilica. But on the first basilica, it was all made of wood. There were no gold leaves that you're seeing right now. It was only wood. And this is the only thing that wasn't destroyed. And some say that this hasn't been destroyed because this keeps like doing the miracles happening and happening. So this is why some say that she still hasn't burned. If you look at this down, there's a rose window. This rose window looks like the one in Notre Dame de Paris, like the cathedral. It looks really like this one. And if you see from outside, you don't see any color, just for you know. The only side, gonna have six statues. This represents the 12 apostles that are represented over there. And if you look a little bit down, you're gonna see an angel. This angel represents the angel of the pilgrims. Because the pilgrims are really important here in Saint Anne de Beaupre, the angel is there for when the people come inside, you'll be protected. So this crazy angel is over there. If you look at this down, you can see a fresco. A fresco with Saint Anne with her horns wide open. Because when people come over here, no matter what is your background, where you're from, everybody is going to the church. This is why you see her over there. You're going to see also three copper doors. This is made of copper. Before, this was not here. It was put like in the 2000s. And this was before in a cathedral in Quebec City. But unfortunately, that cathedral closed, and we had both doors really in reality for that. And also, this was made by a man from here. He lived in L'Ange Gardien. Now he's dead, but we have this unique part over here. This earth is called in French l'art de pousser. And this is like when you do this, you take a sheet of copper and you do like drawing. And then you turn it around again and you just do it again. All the time until that the project is done. This can take a lot of time. And the rectangle, you're gonna see the rectangle. This represents a biblical scene of the Bible. And also just the little rectangle, it took like 9 to 12 months only to do this. It takes a lot of time. And when you look at the door, you're gonna see the door is really heavy. Because the door weighs around 500 pounds, so this is really heavy. And on each one, you're gonna see a signature of the sculpture in the scene. So then every door is gonna have its name written in the cover. So now we're gonna go inside the church. Before we're gonna go into the church, we're gonna go in the lobby. When you're in the lobby, you're not officially into the Basilica. Only when you pass the doors in the lobby, that's when you
go. So just for curiosity, so this is within the science.
Yeah.
This is the only thing that we have more than once in the church, because it's still important.
Over here, we have the Temple of Death.
If you see the tomb, the altar looks like a tomb. And also, you see the column. The column are red, represent the blood. And on the ceiling, you're going to have the tool that they have used and they have put Jesus on the cross also. I just want you to look about the fence over here. At the beginning, we had two fish. But here we have a bird. The bird is a phoenix. You know why the phoenix could be here to the chapel over here? Do you have any suggestion or guesses?
Phoenix comes to life after out of its ashes.
That's right.
Yeah, say it again.
Yeah,
the phoenix rises after death from its ashes.
So when the phoenix dies, burn into ashes, after reborn from its ashes. This is why the phoenix is over here. Mm-hmm. Now we're gonna pass those doors and we're gonna be officiating to the Basilica. Mm-hmm. Over here, to treat the big statue at the front, and they go back home. And sometimes when they go back home, that kind of heal occurred. And when they come back here, they give us the crutches to say a big thank you to Satan. So this is why you see crutches on each side. This is not the only crutches that we have here at the shrine. There are some in the museum, and also we have some crutches in big rooms, because this will not fit into the crutches on each side because it would be too much. So this is why you'll see this dome one over here. If you see on the floor, here again we have kind of three diamonds shape. This represents the three temptations that the human had the most. So over here, this represents pleasure, you know, with wine, comedy. Over there, we have riches, with the jewels, the money, the gold. And the last one over there, this represents honor, glory of the crown, being popular. So this represents glory. We're gonna pass over here.
My clipboard is over there, so I can't reach it. Mahira, Carmel, and Mary Gabriel came 20 plus years ago, right, Mary?
Oh, yeah. I can't remember.
Yeah. And who else on this side? Teresina and David. And I just want to thank God for all the blessings that I've received and that you've received. And we have some cake and strawberries and some good to go with it. So we're going to cut the cake and then we're going to share it. Is that okay? So I'm going to ask Tony to come help me. And yes. That's right. So I just want to.
You've blown a lot of candles, right? 英文的嘛？那个还蛮有意思。